As of July 23, 2023, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is the Fagradalsfjall fissure complex in Iceland, which began its third effusive eruption in 3 years on July 10, 2023, which has so far covered approximately 1 square kilometer in a layer of lava. This volcano is quite fascinating and has been generally good for tourism in Iceland, as it has erupted during 3 consecutive summers, with one eruption in the summers of 2021, 2022, and 2023. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Peru, the Ubinas volcano produced its most powerful blast since its latest ongoing eruption began, sending a plume of ash to an impressive height of 28,000 feet or 8,534 meters. Elsewhere, in Japan, the Kirishima volcano's alert level was raised to yellow in response to fairly recent ground deformation underneath a group of fumaroles known as Iwoyama, which has not been the site of a volcanic eruption since 1768. And in what is this busy week's top story, there is a danger of a potentially destructive lahar or group of lahars occurring on the still-erupting Mayon volcano. This warning was issued on the 45th day of its eruption, as a storm system likely to form a tropical depression is expected to bring rain, potentially heavy rain, to the area around and on the volcano between July 23rd and July 24th. Thus, during this period, you should not cross any riverbeds and streams if it does rain, dry or not, and in my opinion, move to higher ground away from Mayon's 6 km exclusion zone if heavy rainfall does occur. Lahars generally stay within low points in the landscape, such as river channels, but if large enough, can jump partially outside riverbanks. As a whole, lahars have historically caused more fatalities than any other hazard at Mayon, with one example in 2006 killing more than 1,000. While it might not seem like there could be much ash to aid in the generation of lahars from the current eruption, there might be more than is suspected, as during the past week the volcano has produced an increasing amount of ash emissions, which loosely correlated to increasing daily sulfur dioxide emissions. In Peru, the Ubinas volcano has been explosively erupting since June 23rd. This has consisted of intermittent yet powerful volcanic explosions, sending plumes of ash up to a height of 22,000 feet. Because of this, a 4 km exclusion zone in all directions around its summit is in place. Then, on July 21st, its most powerful explosion so far in its ongoing eruption occurred, sending a plume of ash to a height of 26,000 feet. An even larger explosion followed the next day, sending a plume of ash to a height of 28,000 feet. In my opinion, it is quite likely that more such explosions will continue for the next few days with a similar intensity. In Japan, the alert level was raised to yellow at the Kirishima volcano on July 7th. Since this volcano is one of the most active in all of Japan, alert level increases are fairly common at Kirishima. As, since 1979, its central vent known as Shinmodake has been the site of all 7 volcanic eruptions. Thus, when an alert level increase occurs at the overall volcano, it is generally caused by an earthquake swarm or ground deformation at that specific volcanic cone. Yet, instead of ground deformation being detected at Shinmodake, it was reported that ground deformation, which has been ongoing since May of 2023, has been ongoing at a group of fumaroles known as Iwoyama. This highly altered patch of ground has not produced an eruption since 1768. Since this is near a paved road, if an explosive eruption was to occur, it could be potentially deadly. An increased rate of volcanic earthquakes has also occurred, and a 1 km exclusion zone was declared around Iwoyama. It is unknown whether this unrest will result in a volcanic eruption, as only time will tell. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on July 22nd of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.